Hi there.
Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial for my design called Moon River. I've already posted this, published it, whatever, on Instagram, and I told you the story about how my mom always sang that song as I was a child growing up, and it's a very precious, sentimental song for me. Everybody should listen to it. Andy Williams is the one who sang it, I believe, back in 1960, the year of moi. And I really like this design. Here it's pretty much done except for these blue bands, which are the 600 count dual layer blue lagoon. They're all 600 count. Oh no, and these glow in the darks. They're all 300 counts. This one, the border is 600 count. And I'm going to be doing my design, my demonstration bracelet in all 600 count to show that it looks just as lovely. Because I know there's a lot of people who cannot get the thicker 300 count bands. So these will be my colors, A, B, C, D, and E will be how they are referenced. And as you can see here, I kind of almost did the same color scheme. The A is here. The color B are the lemonade pearl bands. C are the where the red. D is the lime green going up here, and which I'm using the Persian 600 count apple green. And then where you can see the blue, which is Michael's neon blue color, I am using the mango. So you're going to need your setup to look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, alternating with the middle one being higher up as well as the outers. I'm going to place two bands here to gather later as the closure. Excuse me. And this is a multi-part design, so I'll show you the first part of placement, then we'll do some looming, then we'll add some more bands, and then we'll do some more looming. So this is what you're going to do with your color band A. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll do it quickly over here. And this 6 count is just for the initial setup placement. After that, it'll be 4 counts. In other words, four band placements and then repeat. It took me a while to work this border out. I kept trying different things. I think I had started out with this one, but I was trying to get something different going on, but I decided this was the best. Okay, so all the way up to the, you know, as long as you want to make it, you'll be going 1, 2, 3, 4, and the repeat 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll show it on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a 4. 1, 2, 3, oops, and 4. And just keep doing that four-step sequence all the way up to, let me see. Okay. Stop at the last, you know, stop at a last full sequence, and the other two bands on each side will just be closing it up. So just, you know, make it as long as you want it by ending with this band here. And I'll be back to show you how to place the last of the border bands. Okay, I'm at the end of my loom. So I'm going to finish by placing one band here and one band here, one here, and one here. So whatever the length of you choose to make it, this is how it looks at the very end. We will eventually be capping that pin. Next, I'm sorry, I'm so out of breath. My heart's just racing a lot, a low blood pressure, so bear with me. I'll try not to sound like some out of breath, out of shape person, which I'm not. You know what the issue is. Anyhow, I'm going to be placing, for me, I like doing it this way because that one seems thin. The easiest, or it just keeps them the neatest. But eventually, the goal is to make triangles. Like this. So it doesn't matter if you do all one side first. Usually, I do it this way to prevent exactly what's happening here is it getting all twisted. On. I figure if you can prevent them from being twisted when you place them, they'll be less twisted when you take them off. I do not get how these women, men, loomers are so neat, like knitters, crocheters, anybody that does detailed work that has to have a nice, even stitch to it. I don't get it. They're so gifted. Neatness, creativity, yes, for me. Neatness, and not so much. So anyhow, that you will be doing this all the way up till you can't do it anymore. What is with these irritating twisted up bands? I'll do one more. And that make them into triangles. Oh, this one's bugging me because it's not right. Okay, I'll do that off camera. Or if you want, you can just, you know, you can place them like this. But see, when I do it, it's super messy. That's why I choose to do it the other way. You don't match in color. So I'm going to fix that off camera. But anyways, you're going to do that all the way up to this triangle. I guess you can do one here, but I'm not sure if I do that. Let me look. Huh, do I or don't I? Okay, yeah, this would be the last one because it's the last free post you have. You don't want to do it on the capping post. So you're going to keep doing it until these two right here and right here are your last triangle placements. Now, pretend all the way up there, all these triangles have been placed. You are then going to take your C color band and place it all the way up like this. Okay, all the way up. I don't think I need to show you how to do that. It's just single chain placement. And I will come back and show you what it looks like with all those B and C colored bands. Alrighty, here is the loom. And I'm going to make a little bit of a correction since I did put these first triangle bands on this pin. Might as well go and put them on this one. So if you've placed your C bands up the center, just take it off. You know, place a band on each side. And then just do that. That's all. Okay. Now we're going to turn it around. Place our cap here. And I will be using two bands because it just makes... I just like the way it, you know, because when you use the 300 count, it automatically makes a thick connection. So I like to double up the thinner bands so that it's nice and beefy. Oh, Jojo, you're already a celebrity. We've already got a bracelet named after you. My Juju kitty. Okay, the first thing we're doing is single chain the C bands, in my case are the red bands, just up the center. To give you an idea, that they're the ones that are going to look like this. See the Persian green? And on here, they're the LE white. And this is how they look red. That's just real quick. I'll probably just stay on camera to do this because it shouldn't take too long. And if I don't stay on screen, you know what I'm doing. I'm just trying to do this quickly. Why are you popping off? All right, this is causing me troubles. I'm not happy. Come on. Oh, my. Gee whiz. One of the problems is this thing isn't staying snapped on. You know, I really haven't been making bracelets lately. I've been doing some of the strand band designs, and I've been sorting out all my beads and getting them in order and cleaning up all the messes I've made making designs. Yeah, I just have personal things going on that have really taken up most of my energy, so I think I've lost a little bit of my dexterity, but we'll get it back. Okay, let's just pretend I finished that. I've done enough of that. The next thing you're simply going to do is bring the tip of these triangles to their two home pins. Their base home pins. You can go up one side, then up the other, but all you're going to be doing is this. Okay, real simple. Of course, you have to do this one first because it's the one, whatever one's on top is the one you do first. That's the only thing you have to do. Okay, so I'll finish that and be right back. Okay. This is what the B and C labeled bands look like after they've been loomed. Now, really important, make sure you turn it back around so the little arrows are facing that way. And we will start placing our D and E colored bands. Okay. The D will be placed a little differently because we're going to place it here and then we're going to reach under, see, under this part of the loomed C band. Okay, see how that looks? Okay, that's the D. The E colors will simply go like this. Now watch carefully. Place this, the D band, reach. It's a little bit tricky, not too bad. See, under. Then place your two E bands. See if I can show this from another angle. This will look, make it easier to see. It's not hard, it's just a little different. We usually just, place on top. We don't go underneath something, but this is my, I try to do a little different take on things. So reach underneath to place one D band, place two E, and I found I like thicker bands for this. They just, like the neon blue here, or actually the lagoon, the dual layer, they're a little bit thicker. The neon blue, even though they're 600 count, are a little thicker. They just show up a little bit better. Let me see. What did I use on for these? Oh yeah, I use Laguna Blue. They show up okay. Okay, here I just use the regular 600 black, which they're just thinner than some of the other 600 counts. And of course they are black, so they're lost in the shadow. Maybe if they were bright yellow, they'd show up better, but they don't show up quite as much, I don't think. So anyhow, that's just a little side note. But whatever you want, just depends how much you want to show them. So reach under, bring it to the next pin. Place your two E colors. Grab another D. I don't know how I come up with thinking things like this, but just something I don't see a lot. I've done a lot, so I thought I'd give it a try, see if it makes something pretty. I do like this design, and I'm liking my Moon River design a little bit more every time I look at it. Close to love. And of course, we all want to love our own designs, but there's others I like and some I love and some I'm just like, oh, I love this so much. Okay, I'll show it a couple more times and then go sit back on my sofa in a more comfortable position and finish placing these. And it is a little bit warmer today, so once again, back in this room, not much airflow, and using the fan just makes so much extra noise. So I'm going to do that, all the way. And if you're not quite sure, wait to do the last three bands, because, or two bands, or the last band here, because you do have to place it underneath the cap, and I will help you with that. Alrighty. I think you hear sugar Juju in the background. I don't think somebody has fed her and she's complaining to me. Because that's her, I'm hungry, somebody please feed me meow. Okay, basically what you do to this last band is exactly what you did in bringing it under the C band. You're going to just reach under the cap and just place it on like that. That's all you have to do. Alrighty, shoo. Okay, now we're ready to do the second part of the looming. Let's see. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. I did my little arrows backwards. hold on. Change it. I got confused looking at my card because I did it backwards. Okay, let's get it. So, see, by placing this one band underneath the cap, now it'll, you know, link attached to it. So this is more very simple looming. One straight up. Bring these two out to their home pins. Straight up. Out to their home pins. Straight up. Out to home pin. And you will do this until all these bands have been loomed. I love this, the Persian apple. The Persian apple and Persian purple are two of the 600 count Persian bands. I just love, love, love the colors. They're so rich and alive and impactful. We're in the home stretch, the border bands, and this, you know, there is a very specific order they have to go in for them to have this, what I think is an attractive looking border. You know, I've tried so many different ways of, you know, placing them in order of looming them that back, and I found this to be the most pleasant. So we'll do the obvious. Take the first couple of bands. To their home pins. These do get a little twisted up, but you know what? In the end, they have a nice loose weave. So if you have to, when you have to snap them back in place, as you can see, these 600 count double-sided, you know, bands are all in perfect position. The same with these here. And I just love the black and white. These black and whites. Which one are the zebras or the penguins? I think they're the zebras. And it's, I just, they make every design pop. Just one of my very favorite bands. Not bands, but you know, bands. Okay. Now, this band right here is going straight up. Not to this, no. Not to the home pin, it's going up to here, okay? Then you're gonna reach under and take this one, because it's on the bottom, and bring it to its home pin. Now see, this one here is all stray. So if you just leave it like that, you know, well, I guess you can bring it back, but this is what I do to make the border look like it does. I reach under here, it's the only one, and I bring it up. It kind of fills in this little gap here instead of bringing it down. It gives a little more body to it. So here we go. One. And the second band, you go two. This is the third. And this is the fourth. So once you get going, it is again, as in the placement, a four-step procedure. So the first step is to take this one straight up. The second one, you also bring straight up, but it originates here. The third one, you reach under and grab this diagonal. Bring it to its home pin, and this one you bring it up to this pin. So it kind of alternates, like the first one goes to the home pin, the second one does not go to the home pin, the third one goes to its home pin, And the last one does not. Okay, so I think that's enough footage on that side. Let me show it on this side. I'm finishing up the initial sequence. Bring this one up. Bringing this one over. Bringing this one over. Now we'll start our 1, 2, 3, 4 sequence. 1, straight up to its home pin, the 2 to a non-home pin, 3, home pin, 4, you're actually going to go over here, non-home pin, 1, home pin, 2, non-home pin, 3, back to its home pin, 4, not to the home pin. So I'll do it a couple more times. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I'm going to go off camera and be back with and show you, finish pulling it off the loom. All I have left is to loom these last 4 bands. I've got this white colored one here that'll work. I thought I had grabbed a large clear clip. So now I'm going to reach down and grab these 2 bands. Cramp, finger cramp, finger cramp. That did not make my finger happy. Okay, so we'll finish this. Design comes off the loom very easily, at least these bands I used here. And while I was off camera, well, this is the back end, but you can see, except for this one's being a little bit of a, oh, there it goes. You can see it's messy up here, but nice and neat. So it just a little bit of this, and it'll all straighten out. You'll see when you see its picture on camera. I mean, on Instagram. I'm not gonna spend my time there, but here it is. Moon River, which I think this one has the colors of Moon River, kind of like the glow of the moon and the twinkling of it off the water and whatnot, and reflection off of trees. That's what it reminds me of. So that one needs a little work on to straighten up the border. And there you have it. Moon River. Thank you so much for watching. And if you like my designs, be sure to subscribe onto this channel at Deb's Thing. And check me out on Instagram at Deb's Thing. Thank you again. Good night.